All right, so in this video, we're gonna set up an admin user so that way we don't have to use our root account. This is very important for making sure that our root account is only used for closing our account and doing root specific activities. We definitely don't wanna be setting it up as the daily driver. So by setting up an administrator account, we could say that admin is gonna be taking care of most of our AWS services, and we'll just fall back to using the root account for closing the account or modifying root account specific changes like we saw in the previous section with billing. Now this involves a couple of steps. One, we have to create an AWS organization. As with any organization, it needs users. As mentioned, we'll create an administrator user, and that administrator needs a set of permissions. And I'll show you what those three steps look like in this video. I'm gonna kick things off by heading over to Identity Center, right over here, IAM Identity Center. And then we want to enable it. Now, as I mentioned, this is going to create an AWS organization, which is great because we want a centralized place to manage our AWS account. So I'm gonna select Enable here, noting that it's going to create it in the US East 1 region. Now, bear with me because there is a lot going on in this section and it's easy to get lost. What we're gonna be doing first is heading over to this multi-account permissions just to verify and get a top level view of the AWS accounts in our organization. As mentioned, this is our root user, this account that we're currently logged into, and it can manage multiple AWS accounts at the same time, which is really great if you have a consultancy where every developer has their own AWS account. However, we're just going to be focusing on this users aspect for now, and we're gonna create an admin user. So I'm gonna select add user right here, and then we'll type in our username, which is gonna be admin. And then we can come over here and enter in our email address, first name, last name, etc. Now, a cool trick, in case you don't know it, is that you can actually specify the root user email address and then say plus admin, and it will treat it as a completely separate email address. Note that you'll still have to log in as an administrator, but this will be the email address that you use. So I'm going to select that. I'll confirm, and then I'll put in my first name, last name, and display name. Great, before we continue, note that we are going to send an actual password to this email address, and it'll be sent to the fundamentals course at focusauto.com email with the plus admin applied to it. Scrolling down, we can skip all of the optional methods here. Feel free to fill them out if that's what you like to do, but I'm gonna click on next. Now, the nice thing about users is that you can put them in groups. So we can have a group of administrators, which means that if I ever wanted to modify what they can do, I can apply those permissions to the group as opposed to going through each individual user and changing their permission level. I'm gonna keep this as is because we're only gonna have the one user in this section. So I can select on next, and then once we come to this page, we can review what we have set up, and then we can have an administrator. Great, so we have this admin user created, but it's only admin in name. It can't actually do anything. We just called it admin. And I can verify that by grabbing the email that was sent to me and coming over here, you can see that I can accept the invitation to become an admin. Great, I'll go ahead and do that, accept the invite, and it's going to immediately ask me to enter in a password. Now, same as before, I'm gonna use one password to create my password here, and I'm gonna call it admin with the password in the fundamentals course admin name. So I'll save this, and then now I can set my new password, and once that is confirmed, I can sign in. Now, what's nice is that our root account is set up so that any new users have to have multi-factor authentication. So even on a user level, you have to be verified. So same process as before, I can come right over here, I have my QR code, and then using the 1Password extension, I can come to my Fundamentals Course admin area, and then click on this dropdown to scan a QR code. I grab the QR code on the screen, so now I can enter in the 6-digit code and select Assign MFA. Great, now I'm done. And from here, I would typically have access to my AWS account, but we didn't assign any permissions, and as you can see, you have navigated to the AWS portal, but we don't have any permissions to actually view anything. Even if I refresh, it doesn't show up. So that's what we're gonna be changing in this section. We have to apply permissions to this admin user. Now that we've created this admin user, we can head over to AWS accounts, and we just wanna add this user to this AWS account. So we have our root account here, which can manage multiple AWS sessions. We have our fundamentals course, which is the AWS account that we're currently in. We can select on that, and now we want to assign users or groups to it. So we can select from the users tab, the admin user, and then over here we can select on next, and then we have to tell what permissions this admin user has the ability to do. So we can select on create permission set. We have a predefined set of permissions, so feel free to explore these. What I can tell you is that the admin access is what we're gonna be using, but the power user access is great for your typical developers because you want them to have a lot of functionality, but not the ability to manage users themselves. But again, we're going to stick with the administrator access role. So we can select on next here. And the one thing I'm going to change is switching this from 1 hour to 4 hours, just because I think logging in every hour is a bit extreme, but a typical development session, right? You want to have 4 hours of development time and then you can re-authenticate. And then there we go. We can select on create from here. You can see that we have administrator access that was already set up. Now there is one thing that I want to tweak. Now in a lot of tutorials, this is essentially where you stop. You have everything taken care of. You can log into your AWS account and you're good to go. But unfortunately, I hear a lot of scares on AWS about the ability to have an EC2 instance, which is a long-running server, set up in your account, and now you get a large bill. And I definitely want to prevent that. So one last thing we're going to do in our root account is click on this permission set for our administrator access. Come down here to where it says inline policy. We're going to select edit. And inside of here, you can paste in specific rules of what you want to allow or disallow. And in our case, we're going to paste in this JSON just like this. And effectively what this means is that this is the version of the policy, hasn't changed since 2012. The statement is all of the actions that you are allowing or disallowing. In our case, the specific ID is going to be called deny EC2 launch. It could be whatever we want. But what we care about is we want to deny the action, which is called EC2 run instance on any resource. So it's not that you can run one EC2 instance, one server, but you can't for another. It's that you can't launch any EC2 instances, again, those high cost, long running servers in your AWS account. Because this is a fundamentals tutorial, I want to go ahead and keep this in place to make sure that no one gets a scare on their bill. So we'll save those changes. And then now we have successfully created an administrator account that doesn't have the ability to launch an EC2 instance. In this section, we've done a lot. So let's verify what we've done so far by doing one more thing, which is heading over to our dashboard. And do you see where it says access portal URL? This is what we use to get into our AWS account. You never go to the actual AWS console. Now I do want to edit this because who's going to remember that subdomain? And we'll just call this like our Focus Otter Essentials. Feel free to name yours whatever you want, but I'm going to grab this and confirm the subdomain and click save. Now this is what you want to have bookmarked anytime you want to access the AWS account. So I'm going to click on this. And once I do, you can see it's prompted me to access my AWS account. Now we have that admin user that we set up before, right? So I can put that person in here, fundamentals course admin. It has MFA and all that stuff. It's navigating to AWS. And now I have the ability for this admin user to select our fundamentals course, log in as an administrator, and finally get access to our AWS account. We no longer have to access our root account, and we now have a very secure setup for our administrator access user. So from here, I'm going to log out of my root user account, just disable that, bookmark this one, and this is what we're going to be using in this course. And with that all set up, I'm going to click done here. I have that bookmark set, and I'll see you in the next video.